disease is affecting us right here, right now, in the United States as well. Can you guys guess what the disease is? It's lung cancer. But unlike COVID, we have a way to reduce the number of deaths caused by lung cancer through a preventive measure. The only problem? Not a lot of people are aware of it. I want to take a quick poll. By raise of hands, how many of you would have guessed that lung cancer is in the top 10 leading causes of cancer-related death? How about top 5? Top 3? The hands are dropping as quickly as my physics grade this semester. What if I told you that lung cancer is a leading cause of cancer-related death in the United States and the world? I work in a lung cancer lab, and I've spent the last year researching lung cancer and working to identify ways in which we can reduce the number of deaths caused by lung cancer. Lung cancer research is important to me because it is estimated that there will be around 240,000 new cases of lung cancer and about 130,000 deaths as a result of lung cancer in 2021 in the United States alone. Now, it's hard to conceptualize the magnitude of this health issue. So I want to compare lung cancer to the next three most prevalent cancers in the United States: breast, prostate, and colon cancer. This graph shows the estimated number of cancer-related deaths for each of the four cancers. And as you can see, lung cancer causes far more deaths than any of the other three cancers. In fact, lung cancer causes more deaths than breast, prostate, and colon cancer combined. With the current incidence rate of lung cancer, it is estimated that 6% of people will develop lung cancer in the United States. That's 1 in 15 men, and 1 in 17 women. This statistic is simply startling. I mean, take a look around you. There are a lot of people in this room. And as startling as it may sound, it's possible that even some of us in this room could develop lung cancer. So now you might be wondering, why is the number of deaths caused by lung cancer so high? Well, it's so high because for most people, their lung cancer isn't caught until the later stages of disease. In fact, for half of lung cancer patients, their cancer is only caught at stage 4, when the cancer is already spread to other locations in the body and is incredibly difficult to remove surgically. Now, we don't need to be surgeons or doctors or researchers to understand that catching a disease earlier is going to be better than catching it once it has already taken over the body. If lung cancer is caught in stage 1 or stage 2, then most of the time, it can be resected during surgery. A surgeon will make a small incision and will remove the cancerous tissue from the lung. And for patients early in the stages of disease, surgery provides the highest success rate because it is the surest way to remove most of the tumor. In contrast, for patients with later stages of disease, surgery is oftentimes no longer an option because the cancer has already grown too large or spread to other locations in the body. The number of individuals surviving at least 5 years past initial diagnosis is 14 times more for individuals with stage 1 lung cancer than for individuals with stage 4 lung cancer. So it is incredibly important that we work to increase the number of patients who are diagnosed at stage 1. You would likely only realize you have lung cancer after going to a doctor, seeing that your cough is still persistent after several weeks. Coughing, shortness of breath, and chest pain are symptoms consistent with the flu and COVID, but they're also consistent with lung cancer. What a stealthy creeper lung cancer is, isn't it? And for individuals who finally realize that they do have lung cancer, it's a difficult situation. Because at this stage, for most patients, they have stage 4 lung cancer, and their prognosis or course of disease is likely poor. For most patients, they only have a few years to live. So the diagnosis of lung cancer has to wait until patients finally start feeling the symptoms of lung cancer. Lung cancer treatment is not going to be as effective. Finding a way to diagnose lung cancer early has been the focus of lung cancer research for years. And we finally have a solution. And that is low-dose computed tomography screening, more commonly known as CT screening. A CT scan is like a spiral X-ray. As a patient moves to the machine, X-ray detectors will circle around the patient's torso. The X-rays will image individual slices of the patient's lung, just like slices of a loaf of bread. And a computer will put together these individual slices to create a detailed picture of the structures within the lung. This is an image of a CT scan from a patient. Soft tissue show up in gray, and water and air show up in black. This image actually shows a tumor in a patient's lung. Can you guys find where it is? Yeah, it's right here. So this blob, or massive tissue circled in red, is a tumor. And while this tumor is relatively large, radiologists can find tumors as small as 2 to 3 millimeters in size, which is about the length of a pushpin. Now, some people are worried about the cost of screening, thinking that it will cost thousands of dollars. And while the cost of American healthcare isn't ideal in many ways, with regard to lung cancer screening, it's not too bad. The cost of a CT scan is about $300. But for those who are at high risk for lung cancer, Medicare and Medicaid services will often cover this cost in many states. Many studies have shown that CT screening can increase the number of cancers caught in stage 1 and stage 2. And one of the most famous studies in the field is called the Nelson trial. The Nelson trial recruited about 16,000 patients, men and women, between the ages of 50 and 74, and randomly split them into two groups. The first group received CT screening 4 times over the span of 5.5 years. And the second group received no screening of any kind. And the results of the study showed that in the screening group, about 60% of lung cancers were found in stage 1. But in the no screening group, less than 15% of lung cancers were found in stage 1. And as we would imagine, with the earlier detection of lung cancer in the screening group, there was a 30% reduction in lung cancer mortality in the screening group when compared to the no screening group. People don't know who should get screened, when they should get screened, or why they should get screened. The current lung cancer screening guidelines state that individuals who meet the following three criteria should get screened for lung cancer annually. And the three criteria are: 1, be between the ages of 50 and 80 years; 2, have a 20-pack-year smoking history or more; and 3, be a current smoker or have quit within the past 15 years. But what even is a 20-pack-year smoking history? A 20-pack-year smoking history is simply a way to describe a patient's smoking history. And a pack year is calculated by multiplying the number of packs a person consumes per day by the number of years they've smoked. So if a person smokes one pack a day for 20 years, that's a 20-pack-year smoking history. Alternatively, if a person smokes two packs a day for 10 years, that's also a 20-pack-year smoking history. So a patient who meets all three of these criteria must be screened for lung cancer annually because they have a high chance of developing lung cancer. Now, a common misconception about lung cancer is that it only occurs in smokers. But this is not entirely the case, because 10 to 20% of lung cancers occur in never smokers. There are additional risk factors for lung cancer, such as exposure to secondhand smoke, radon, and asbestos, as well as a family history of lung cancer and COPD. Furthermore, vaping and e-cigarette use is increasing exponentially in young adults and adolescents, making it a significant cause of concern for the future. But these additional risk factors are difficult to quantify, so they're currently not accounted for in the lung cancer screening guidelines. But it is imperative that we work to modify the current screening guidelines to identify high-risk never smokers with further research. But at this moment, the current screening guidelines are still the best resource patients have to determine whether or not they need to be screened. The only problem is, not a lot of people know about these screening guidelines. And few people know that CT screening can be used to detect lung cancer. So I want to take a quick poll again. How many of you know when Lung Cancer Awareness Month is? No hands. Well, don't be afraid, don't be embarrassed, because a lot of people don't realize that there even is a Lung Cancer Awareness Month at all. And guess what? It's November, this month. What's surprising to me is that, in contrast, a lot of people know that October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. The pink breast cancer ribbon has become a universal sign of breast cancer, and we see it everywhere. In hospitals, on shirts, on cars, the list goes on. We've made great progress creating awareness about breast cancer screening through mammograms, and we should aim to do the same for lung cancer. Unfortunately, despite medical advancements, there still exists a stigma around lung cancer because people think that only smokers get lung cancer because of the lifestyle they choose, and therefore they somehow deserve their disease. Educating people about lung cancer and how it can occur in anyone, not just smokers, is key to removing the stigma around lung cancer. The scientific community was able to build such sophisticated CT screening technology, but we're still having trouble getting the word out about lung cancer screening. And when we have a way to prevent the number of deaths caused by lung cancer, it seems unfathomable and even irresponsible not to educate people about it. If a person wants to get CT screening, they can talk to their primary care physician to see whether lung cancer is the right choice. Lung cancer screening is the right choice for them. And even if an individual doesn't meet the screening guidelines, their awareness about the screening guidelines can still help a family member or friend who might need to get screened. Just imagine the grief, frustration, regret of having a family member or loved one die of lung cancer, knowing that had the disease been caught earlier, it could have been saved. In the present moment, there are many different health issues facing our country and our world. With some health issues like COVID, we are still struggling.